Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Since I uploaded the walk around video for the Land Cruiser 70, a few of you asked me a question about how does this car feel to drive. So this is my attempt at answering those questions with my feedback. To be honest, I don't have any complaints with this car because, you know, I bought it knowing exactly what this car can and cannot do. But that being said, the car that I'm driving right now, the 71 series, the one they sell in the UAE, this is fairly loaded. So as you can see, I'm not, shifting any gears because this has a V6 petrol engine with an automatic gearbox, a 6-speed automatic gearbox. And that is the same engine and transmission they had on the outgoing Land Cruiser Prado and the FJ Cruiser. So it's a tried and tested drivetrain. It's really good for off-road applications. And to be honest, right now I'm cruising at 120 kilometers per hour. And whatever wind noise you guys can hear, that is what I'm hearing as well. But for me personally, it's not that loud, especially if you're not driving into the wind. If you get a bit of tailwind, you know, the car is very, very manageable when it comes to the noise inside the car. And also this car is not soundproofed from the factory, but I'm planning to add some sound deadening material under the bonnet and inside the body panels in the door and at the back, just to try and see if that makes a difference in the cabin noise, because I plan to drive this car to Saudi Arabia in a few months, and that will be a long drive. I think about 4,000 kilometers in about 10 days. So yeah, it would be nice to have that done before I leave. But overall, in terms of really drivability in this car, that's the reason why I bought it, because I really wanted to have one car that I like that I could drive every day. And when the facelift version for the 70 series arrived in late 23, you know, when I saw what Toyota had done with the car, you know, I decided, yes, this is it, this is for me. Because having an automatic transmission for day-to-day use, you know, is a big advantage. And also the version that I am driving comes with a lot of creature comforts from the factory. So you get you get Apple CarPlay wireless, Android Auto wireless, you get automatic headlights. You get a really good air conditioning system, though it's not automatic, but you know, it's quite adequate for this car. And you get two USB power outlets, you get a cigarette lighter outlet, you get, in terms of safety, you know, you get, this car is quite safe. I think it's got a 5-star NCAP rating. And also the fact that this has a few more safety features, like lane keep assist, so it doesn't actually keep the car inside the lane, but it does notify you with a clear warning when you are deviating from your lane without indicating. And it also has forward collision alert system. Again, it doesn't slow you down, but it gives you an audible beep and the display goes red. It beeps red for a few seconds, alerting you that you're getting too close to the car in front without applying the brakes. And that's a feature, I believe, which is on all the time. So it's not just when you have your cruise control activated, but also when you're driving normally. So yeah, there are these features, like simple things like, your rear view mirrors, you can control them from inside, stuff like that on a Land Cruiser 70 series. Makes a big difference. And the seats are not the most comfortable seats, of course, but again, I have bought this car knowing exactly what I'm buying and what I'm gonna get, and I really, you know, enjoy driving this car. And for daily use, you know, having short trips from your house to work and back, it's not a problem. When you go off-road, you really don't care about the seats much. This even has this upgraded steering wheel compared to the previous model. So, you know, that's another thing I really like about this car. You know, it's a very nice feeling steering wheel with lots of keys and buttons on the steering wheel themselves. So, you know, that again adds to a bit of convenience to a car like this. But overall, on the road, I have no issues. I'm currently driving off-road, and we're gonna start in about 10 minutes. So I'm gonna shoot a bit of my off-road driving experience from inside the car as well, which will be the second part of this video. Right, off-road driving impressions. You will see in some of these clips that, you know, we attempted a fairly, I would say, difficult washed out section in the mountains after the rain in the UAE. And even now I'm probably going up what looks like close to about a 20 degree or a 25 degree incline, and I've got the car in 4 high, and it's got just 4 high engage, no diff locks. Even the traction control is on at the moment, because I think it acts a bit like the crawl control in the 300 series. And yeah, the fact that it's an automatic, it's such a different experience compared to driving a 70 series manual off-road. There's not much input required. You're not stressing the drivetrain a lot. Absolutely no clutch engagement issues here. So yeah, it is very easy to drive this off-road in a much better way now, because some of the sections we did were completely washed out with like almost boulders where the track was supposed to be. So even now it's fairly extreme, but yeah, the 70 series, you know, it holds on, and it just goes through pretty much everything you throw at it. And even now I'm really enjoying driving this off-road. You know, only a couple of occasions I had to engage the front and the rear diff locks, but other than that, 4 high took me everywhere. Wherever the climb was too steep, I moved to 4 low. And once you move to 4 low, the traction control and the stability control just turns off. So yeah, right now we're pretty high up. I'll show you what I see in front. You will see a nice view. So you can see we're pretty high up here in the UAE. I think we're about 1,000 meters or so above the ground, above the sea level, sorry. Yeah, so there it is, guys. I think, my 2 cents on how the 70 series drives on road and off road. And another interesting thing is, now that I'm going downhill, it's quite steep, I have the option of hill descent control, which again does a great job. Hill descent control in 4 high along with traction control feels a bit like, you know, the crawl control on the 300 series. And we have a 300 series in today's group, and you know, I was in that car for a bit, and yeah, it feels exactly that. So I think all of this modernization of the 70 series has really helped bring the car up to the level where even hobbyists like me and enthusiasts like me can actually enjoy the off-road capabilities of the chassis and the drivetrain. You know, if you're not so good with driving manual cars off-road, or you know, the clutch control could be an issue, etc., then I think a 70 series in the automatic transmission option is ideal for you. So yeah, the only other thing is that it's way too bouncy inside the car, thanks to the leaf spring at the back. The front feels okay, but the rear just wants to throw you all over the place. You know, even now, if I was in a Jeep or if I were in a Land Cruiser right now, this 300 series, I wouldn't be bouncing around so much. But yeah, there is no rattle, no squeak. You know, it's a Toyota fit and finish, so you can't complain. But yeah, I think that's something you really have to live with if you have this car. And I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. And if you want to know more about the car, just comment below. And please subscribe to see some more cool videos of me driving the 70 series around. And if you guys are, you know, somewhere close to me in the UAE, reach out to me. Probably we could go out for a drive. So that's it, guys. Thank you for watching. See you again soon.